Porcelain Parasite here, and welcome to another episode of Binary Builds. It has been way too long since I did one of these, like, way too long. I think it's been months, and I'm really sorry about that. Hopefully you guys saw the update video on this channel, and Binary Builds is coming back weekly, so yeah. If I don't get them out weekly, they will definitely be bi-weekly, but I'm hoping for a weekly video. And I even have a challenge from one of my wonderful subscribers that is coming up for next week's binary builds that I'm in the process of making. Anyways, this build is, I don't know, it was sort of future inspired. I just wanted to make a sort of futuristic house, and that's basically all I went on. I wanted to make a sort of square futuristic house because I'm not used to making futuristic properties, and also I love this pool. This pool that ends up being made my favorite part of the house. Just saying, that's my favorite part of the house. But yeah, it's great to be back, and yeah, it's just wonderful to be building in The Sims again, to not have my computer overheat every time I try and run The Sims or try and edit a video. It's such a relief to actually be able to do this, so yeah. I'm also really glad I didn't have to buy a new computer in order for this to happen. I just had to basically clean mine up and change around a few things with settings and stuff, and finally got it to work again. And I'm back, and I'm really happy. Yeah, so I'm just in here. I'm putting in the rooms right now, and yeah. Also, I have some vlogs that I plan on putting out soon. I'm gonna do a week of camping related videos, including my camping vlogs from last year. And so I'm hoping to do a full week of content for you on this channel coming up within the month of August. So next month, 1 week will hopefully be 7 videos. So I'll have a video out every day. I've never done a week of putting out a video every day, so it's definitely gonna be a challenge, but I'm really up to the challenge and I think it'll be exciting. And I hope you guys will like how it turns out. I'm in the process of editing those videos right now, and it's just like, I don't know. I don't know. It's some of them, because they're old, because they're camping vlogs from last year. It's just like there. I do things in them that I wouldn't do this year because I've learned a little bit from, especially from doing YouTube over on my main channel, Manufactured. So yeah, it's just kind of weird and awkward to watch them back while editing them. But I think they're still pretty good, and I think you guys will enjoy them. And I did put in all these big, just generic room lights. I take most of them out, but those are a by debug, like, prop that you can use. But it helped me a lot basically doing this entire build, because I did have mostly white walls and stuff, and I wanted everything to look very clean. Yeah, and I'm here, I'm trying to pick trees that can go in these columns, and I pick all these palm trees, and I think that would just look really cool to be sitting on that deck and just looking out through this row of trees. It would definitely give you a little bit more of a feeling of privacy, even though there's not leaves and stuff hanging down. You'd still probably have more of a feeling of privacy on your deck just because those trees are there. And I don't know, it was a really cool, interesting design thing that I came up with that I think works actually very, very well. Moving them around. Yeah. Sorry, I'm a little out of breath. I just finished recording. I should have probably taken a break before recording this. I really need to have a little bit more foresight into these things, but I did just finish recording this week's episode of Sunday Sketch Talks, the voiceover for that. Now I'm recording the voiceover for this one, so yeah, hopefully my voice will last this entire video. And yeah, this one's just like a little thing that I did for myself, like, oh, I wanted to build a future house, so I built a futuristic house. But like I said, next week I'm doing a request from another viewer who has actually been waiting for it for a little while, and he's been very, very patient. And I didn't notice until just recently, but a couple months ago he made like a little shout out video to me saying like, oh, I'm gonna do my request and stuff. And I am still gonna do your request. I feel bad I didn't see that video until now, but it was awesome and it really touched me that you enjoy my content that much. I'm always surprised when people you know, leave really detailed comments or just do things saying like, oh, I miss you. Like, I had someone on my main channel comment that asking about when my next Sunday Sketch Talks video was going to come out, and it just really touched me because you make these videos on YouTube and you do see like how many views they get and things like that, but you don't always know how much people are liking them or like what each person's individual experience of your videos is, whether they're liking them a lot, whether it's just something they watch because there's nothing else to watch, you know, the subscription feed's empty. But when people sincerely miss my content or are really excited about the next episode of one of my series coming out, it just really touches me, and it's like, I don't know, it just gives me this really awesome feeling. It's like I say, I've said this before, but my favorite part of being on YouTube is the comments. I know a lot of people get like toxic comments and stuff, but the comment section can also be a really wonderful place, and when I read a comment that is detailed and, or not even just detailed, but a comment that I know you've watched the video, like you're responding to something I said or something, I don't know, that just, it just makes me feel good about myself, because it makes me, it proves to me that people are actually watching my videos and actually enjoying them, and I don't know, that's just such a cool thing when you make something and someone, basically when you make something and you just stick it out there, when people actually grab onto it and enjoy it, that's what you want them to do, and yeah, it's a great feeling, so yeah. Anyways, I've talked about that for a little while now, and my voice is already going, so I'm going to have some water. Okay, that should be good. I should be a bit better. As you see, I stuck a bunch of stuff on that front lawn there that I wanted to use in this build, so yeah, it was just like, oh, I want to use these things, so I just stuck them all there. And I put in all these charging stations for robots because I figure that the father figure, or maybe the mother figure of this family, is an avid inventor. I give him a lot of high-tech stuff in that little area outside the master bedroom, so yeah. Sorry. Whew. And putting in bedrooms, so I think this is a 4-bedroom, yeah, it is a 4-bedroom, 2-bathroom house, I believe. There are 2 double bedrooms for the kids of the family, probably males, but they could be females too, you never know. And then there is a guest bedroom, which is this big white bedroom here that I just stuck that thing in, but it doesn't stay. that big white room is the guest bedroom, and it's kind of scary how just completely white that bedroom ends up in the end. So they also have a bunch of stuff for their pet upstairs, and I added in this section here. I was going to use carpeting for grass because I was used to doing that, but then I remembered that they added in rugs as like grass tiles as part of the future, whatever the future pack is called, but as part of the future pack, they added these grass rugs, which I was like, yeah, I can just use those, and I did, and which is perfect for a future build since they're from that pack, but yeah, so I made these little like indoor garden spaces just because everything was just so white and so stark that it just needed a little bit of color, but I didn't want to bring in color in a traditional way, so I figured some little indoor gardens and fountains and things would be a great way to break up that really just blank slate and give it some color and give it some personality without making it seem like it was just any normal traditional house, like giving it its own identity as this very future home, and adding in fountains too, which is pretty cool. Have fountains in your house. You'd probably have to have a lot of money to constantly have fountains running and to also have a pool and have all this high-tech workshop stuff upstairs. And yeah, the master bedroom, now that I look at it looking back, it is a tiny, tiny room. I mean, they have all that workshop space outside of it, which is probably why the master ended up so small, but It's just such a tiny room. At least they have a whole floor to themselves, but they also have tiny closets as well, which probably wouldn't be too much fun. Yep, adding in some cupboards there. And lighting. Oh yeah, those lights. I love those lights. They work so well. Worked very well there. And above all the doors, I think they look really cool. And I actually really enjoyed my use for almost every door in this house except for the master bedroom doors. I used the, like, tomb passageway door, but I used the recolor tool to make it this metal sort of texture, so it looks very futuristic, because I didn't want traditional, like, turn the handle doors. I wanted just, like, automatic opening doors, so that was my little choice to make that happen, and I think it actually turns out really well for the aesthetics of the home. I'm not sure if I go with those chairs. I might change those chairs. Or maybe I leave them. Can't quite remember. I guess we'll find out. I did just finish building this not long ago, but yeah, I guess we'll find out. I'm very good at forgetting what things stay in my builds and what things don't, because I am notorious for going back and changing things later. I do... Most of my builds are not built in a single sim session, especially because watching a build like this, like this one's 36 minutes, this video will be around 36 minutes. I can already see as it's going through, but for a 36 minute video, you have to understand that this is sped up significantly. So this build probably took me around 6 hours, maybe a little bit more than that. 6 to 8 hours, I would say this build took me. So it wasn't completely built in one session. None of my builds are. Actually, the artist cottage, I think, might be. But that's because it was so small. Most of my builds are built in 2 or 3 sessions of playing The Sims. And so it's easy for me to go back and change things later, because I'll make one decision one day that I won't like the next day, so I'll change it. And that happens a lot, and that's why I get this confusion over what stays and what goes. But anyways, yes, this is my little excuses there. Yeah, not everything being built in one full session. I mean, I guess I could do one. I could challenge myself to do a smaller one and do it all in one session, but it just doesn't happen. Like I said, I've started building the request from that other viewer. I think their name's Comedy here on YouTube, but I'm not completely sure, so don't quote me on that. That's what their icon says, though. Yeah, and if you're watching this, shout out to you. Thanks for your request, and thanks for missing me. But yes, I enjoy making... I'm just not good at this evening, I'm sorry. Terrible voiceover. I make things in multiple sessions. So that one, that request, I've made the entire outline for the house so far, and I've furnished, I think, 2 of the rooms, and that's it. And so I'll probably go back in and furnish another, like, 4 rooms or something, and then go back in another time over the course of the week, and then freak out when it reaches Sunday and I'm like, oh no, I have to finish this so I can voice over and edit it quickly and have it uploaded. Anyway, yeah, working on this bathroom here, which is actually, I think, one of my favorite bathrooms that I've done so far. I love that mirror that I used, and little counter space that I put in and stuff, and it's just nice and spacious. I'm used to having to cram bathrooms into smaller spaces, but since this house is so large, I was able to, you know, pack it with more stuff than usual, give them a little bit more counter space, and a separate tub and shower, which is great. Yeah, and then working on this room, that little chest fits in at the end of the bed there so well. And it just looks really cute. And I went with a lot of blues in this house, as you'll see, because most of the walls are, and most of the furniture and stuff, not just the walls, but most of the futuristic things come with this white and blue color pattern, which you could do a white and anything color pattern. You could do a gray and something pattern. for a futuristic build, you could do lots of different things, but I do like the white and blue, and I took most of my inspiration from that, and it also saved me a lot of time having to recolor things. I still do, as you see, go in and change the colors of so much stuff in my builds. It takes me forever, especially because that's when my game likes to lag, but luckily when it's sped up, you guys don't notice it. it would really suck if you guys could notice it, but you don't, which is great because this is way faster than it actually takes me to build these. And yeah, so building this bedroom. This is what I envisioned for the younger two children of the family. And yeah, I made the kids' rooms in sets of two instead of giving them each their separate rooms. So if you were playing this, maybe you would want your family, maybe they had two sets of twins or something, and that'd be pretty cool that's what happened and that's what they gave the rooms to. But you know, it could be anything at all. So this is the kids' room, and I love the penguins on that dresser. I think they're so cute. And yeah, making my little corner bookshelf like I like to do. Or wait, yeah, maybe I leave it like that. Actually, yeah, I think that's how I leave it. Just to make it look thicker so that it just blends in more. It, yeah. Play in with the furniture and custom content and everything. They're trying to decide what's going to go on the desk. Little kitty. Yep. And then some art for their walls. I use that Wonderbolts poster, which is definitely custom content, but it looks so good. Like, that's a great poster. Often when people make fan posters to put in The Sims, they aren't the highest quality, but those ones are really, really good. And those are, of course, from TSR, The Sims Resource, as most of my custom content comes from The Sims Resource, just because it's so easy to mod from that website. And I don't put a lot of complex mods in my game, they're mostly aesthetic, because most of what I do is building, as you can tell with my entire binary build series. Although I am still very much considering doing a Let's Play of The Sims, and I have my family and stuff all set up for it, I'm just not sure. I'm still holding off. I'm like, I do want to do a Let's Play for sure, I'm definitely not used to it. I'm not used to speaking at the same time as I'm playing, so I'm kind of nervous, but I think I should probably just try it and jump into it and then see how I do, because I didn't know how this was going to turn out when I first made it. I just was used to seeing other people build in The Sims, and I was like, hey, I like building in The Sims. I could probably share my stuff with the world and they might like it, so I might as well try, because at least I'm gonna be having fun. I would be building these things anyway, so why not record it? But yeah, I'm not, like I said, I'm not used to also talking at the same time. I do these builds while listening to stuff instead of talking, and then I just speak over them after they're all sped up and such, but to actually speak while doing like a Let's Play would be interesting. And probably I'd drink a lot of water, because as you can tell, my voice gets really rough. And as I say that, I'm gonna have more water. Yes. Alright, upstairs. Working on this bathroom, which I also like. And I just stuck that kiddie pool prop in there for a second, because I was like, hey, this thing fits. It's pretty cool. But that definitely wasn't a serious consideration. I definitely wasn't going to keep that there. And yeah, I never noticed how this washer and dryer actually connect before, and it was just really cool. I really liked that. So that's what I did. I used those upstairs. So they do have laundry, and I think I do put laundry baskets in some of the rooms, but not all of them. So if I do put this house up for download, if I finally figure out what's wrong with the TSR and why it doesn't like me uploading things, then I will, you know, then when you take it and put it in your game, you might want to consider either taking out the laundry facilities or just adding some laundry baskets to the rooms that don't already have them. It would be pretty easy to just add laundry baskets just because it is such a big house, but yeah. So finishing off that bathroom, and also, oh, that TV stand that goes in there, I love it too. It just fits in so well with the futuristic house. And yeah, here I'm just like moving around, like, what am I gonna do? What am I gonna put in next? And how am I gonna fill this space? And put in that little whiteboard there, because I don't know, it just looks pretty cool. And oh, and I put in these four easels here that all sort of go together. And it's kind of an odd choice to have these four easels that just sort of cross each other in the middle of the room, but I don't know. I figure maybe there's a few artists in the family, or maybe one of them teaches art courses or something. And it was just a very, very odd idea, and I was like, it'll work in a future house. And I put this little lounge area in here, which I love. Love this little lounge area. It seems like a great space to entertain, especially in this open, like, entertainment area. This house would actually be very good for entertaining, but yeah, and then I put all these lights in here, and I play around with putting, like, a curtain in sort of to separate that space, but it just didn't look quite right to me, so I didn't end up putting it in, but I don't know, it's still a cute space, and I still really like it. I also played around with doing that, and yeah, I didn't realize that ottoman, or some of the ottoman type blocks, it would try and automatically connect to, so that was an interesting thing to discover. And putting in that table there as well, and I stuck a little cookie jar on it, and it just looks really cute, and like a great entertainment space for this future family. And then those lights that I stuck up there, which are from University Life, I think. They're a great asset. There's actually a lot of great building things, or especially home decor type items that come with University Life. I think it's one of the best for getting items to build in The Sims. It just comes with so many items that I like to use in my builds now. I'm surprised that I could build without it. And I put in this long shelf there that's actually backlit, so it continues with the futuristic feel, and there's a little more of a dark tone to this specific bedroom, which I think suits the older two children, because this bedroom is for the older two children. And that bed there, those two beds are, like, those are two separate beds. One of those is a loft bed, and one of them is just the main base bed, because I didn't want to have the same bunk bed for each of the kids, each of the kids' rooms. But I just really like how it turned out, and those two beds mesh really, really well. I forget what each of them are called, but as you can see them right there. Those two beds work really, really well together. I was surprised. They look like they're just one item, which is really cool. Choosing what lights to put in here. Sorry, getting more water. And trying to decide what else to do with this room. There's sort of, as you can see, there's that like special sleep chamber, but then there's also a treadmill for them to work out. And trying to decide what to put on that podium, just grabbing some stuff from outside, putting in a chair for them to sit at. And then moving over here, I knew I needed to have a dresser, and I also needed to have a bookcase, and I like that dresser, so I was like, maybe I could put it in, but I would have to connect it to something, because as you can see, it ends off there. It's also a piece of custom content, I think, but it is quite useful. I wish, though, you could flip it, but I end up putting these shelves in here so that it sort of, you know, masks that edge and makes it all make sense, and I think I put a mirror above it. Yeah, I do. Yep, I put that mirror there, and that mirror actually goes really well with the bookshelves that are next to it, so yeah, I think that little area worked out quite well, and I'm quite happy with it. And these little mirrored desks, or do I not do the mirrored desks? No, I do these desks, don't I? Yeah, I do. Make this little desk area. It's not the best office area I've done, but it had to be a sort of futuristic, unique office area for that could accommodate basically both the kids, and I really enjoy that printer that I stick in there. I love that piece of custom content. At least I'm pretty sure that printer is custom content. Just a mod, and it's just really, really nice to have a printer. There's just those little, like, those little fine details that you don't see in The Sims, because they aren't really useful to The Sims game overall, but it's nice to have those little items that just make a home feel more like a home. And trying to add things to the walls. I use that, that little, what's it called? Bulletin board. I use that tiny little bulletin board thing. Cork board. What do you call them? Cork board? Anyways, I use that item way too much in my builds. I definitely need to find a few alternatives to that. I'll try and look for some mods that are alternatives to that, but I use it a lot because I like it a lot. And as you can see here, I am working on the little gardens, which give this home its little pop of color, which I think is especially nice down by the kitchen. You can sit and eat and listen to the fountains, and I don't know, I think it would just be a really nice environment to have, you know, a nice family meal in. They got that big table in there for their family meals, and yeah, putting in all these flowers. Trying to decide what flowers to put in. And yeah, then I move upstairs, add in all of the pet things. So obviously they have a cat. I said they have a pet, but yeah, obviously it's cat with that big scratchy post and the cat toys and things and all the stuff for their kitty upstairs. And then I end up putting in some stuff for the workshop, which takes up this basically this entire space, but they do end up getting a desk upstairs as well. So whoever the partner is that isn't the inventor in this family, they get their own space as well. And I'm sure they're thankful. They're thankful to have that, especially since the master bedroom is so small. And they also don't get an ensuite bathroom, and I like to make ensuite bathrooms for the masters, but, you know, doesn't always work out. And actually, in most of my builds that you've seen on this series, I don't think there are. I know the last one there wasn't, the artist cottage there wasn't, but that was like a single person home. I don't know. Trying to think. Anyways, yes. Add in that little laundry bin, and the master bedroom was also, because of its size, so difficult to take screenshots of for the end of the video, but, you know, you work with what you have. And I had to put a curtain in there because those doors are see-through, and there is an open staircase up to the next floor, so, you know, if they wanted a little privacy, they got some glass doors there, then it's not going to give them much privacy. Anyone can walk up those stairs and see in their bedroom. So I gave them some curtains to give them a little bit of privacy, and I'm sure they would appreciate that. I'm trying to put in some lights now because I forgot about lighting basically since I had these giant things lighting up the rooms. But I do leave these debug items to light up most of the rooms, which you won't even see in your normal Sims game when you're actually in the play mode. They don't show up at all, which is really nice. And I don't know, in a future home, they would probably have some high-tech lighting like that, at least in part of their house. Yes, moving on to the guest bedroom, which I make this completely white. That was my vision. They have this little dream pod here, which I think would be the source of most of the color and life to this room. It's mostly for sleeping in, but it also is really accommodating. So we have this little table I put in, make it all white, and I put in these little modded windows because I didn't want to put real windows in. But they have these like fake windows. It feels like a really surreal space and kind of uncomfortable for me. I don't know that I would want to stay there if I was someone's guest, honestly, especially since it's just so completely white and I'd feel like maybe I was in a padded room or something. It doesn't feel completely safe. I'm just like completely tearing apart my own work, but I don't know. I was inspired to do it and I was like, I'm going to do this. And they get a full bathroom all of their own in that room with the single cube bathroom thing that The Sims has now. So yeah, they have all the little accommodations, and they do have a couple little things. They have a little bit of writing utensils and a plant in there, and I'm sticking in like a chair and a towel or something, but yeah, it's just everything is so white in this room, and Yeah, I don't know who in the family chose to decorate it this way, but I think it might be a little bit overwhelming for any of the guests. Also, they have a TV, at least. I would always have that TV going so that there was just some color in that room of some sort. Yeah. And here, working on the back with this pool because I didn't want to keep it all completely blue, so I end up changing that bit as well. But I do really like this pool. I don't know, I just like how it frames that little side of the house and makes it seem less like just a box. So, yeah, this pool. And then I end up putting in this just really strange area here. I don't know, it has really strange... I used these, like, big glass blocks, which I think are from the Sims 3 store. But just to make this area. So, I don't know, it ends up very, very strange. These glass blocks here. And then this glass block on the bottom. The glass block on the bottom, as there's three pieces, but the one cube on the bottom ends up glitching out at one point, and so I can just automatically see through the ground. I don't know if that's how it was intended to be in the first place, and it just didn't do that when I had first put it down, but at some point it ends up doing that, and so I have to go in and change all the ground underneath it and make this pretty cool, like, basement space with a plant growing out of it and some water and color all that in green. Which you'll notice at one point, at least in the screenshots. And working on this deck, I gave them a nice little bar. Yeah, a little bar, some chairs to sit and lounge around, you know, at home. Put them back in that space, and yeah, they have their robot workstation is also on the deck, just because it didn't fit in the main workshop area of the house, but I still wanted them to have it, especially because there are all those different charging stations in the home. And yeah, I like that bar area too. I think it looks classy and also futuristic, so I'm quite proud of that. And then I go around changing all these tiles, and I'm not really happy with how they end up in the end. I feel like the best ones I had were there were these really, like, white tiles that I had at one point that I think I was the most happy with, but I don't know, I ended up changing it, and I'm just not that happy with how the floor turned out for the deck and the roof, but, you know, there's always things we would do differently. Yeah, I'm not completely happy with that. I actually liked the lighter ones a lot better. And then we add a little driveway area and some stations for their futuristic, I don't know, riding machines, whatever they're called. And they just go on bike stands, which I find really funny. But, you know, see, when I move it there, it leaves a little hole in the ground. I was like, what happened? And then I kind of freaked out there and had to fix it, but I think it ends up all right. And a driveway. Yeah, I'm painting in this driveway area here. And I didn't do a lot of terrain paint around the rest of the house just because I wanted it to feel very clean, just to go around, like, to fit in with the interior of the house. So I didn't want to add in, like, more realistic touches like dirt around the gardens and stuff like that just because I wanted it to feel very pristine, like the inside, and go with that whole theme. And here you can see me working on this tiny little space and adding in a pool and stuff, and recoloring it all to green, which doesn't matter because when you look through from the top, it looks blue anyway. but, you know, what can you do? I still think it looks pretty cool. Still think it looks okay. And I think I add in a car here as well. Yeah, I do. I definitely add in one of the futuristic cars. That one right there. And yeah, here we are in screenshots. So this is the top of the house. This is the third floor, the second floor, and the main floor. This is the front with the car. You can see that little area there. The little patio where you get out of the pool, into the pool. I love how you can actually swim to get into the house. This is at night. This house really shines at night. I feel like it looks so good in the nighttime, so that's where when most of my screenshots are taken, the front door. Here is the kitchen with its little fountains and stuff. I love that kitchen area. It looks very clean. And those doors. Ah, looks really good. I enjoy it. The little garden areas. The little sitting area over there. Another garden. Here is the main floor bathroom. And the young kids' room. With its desk and that poster. Yeah, some little alien toys. Up to the second floor, we have that little lounge area and the family TV area. And into the guest bedroom with all the white. its little desk area there and its own private bathroom, which you can see there, the all-in-one bathroom. Then this is the second floor bathroom, which has the laundry and is again a full bathroom, full four-piece bathroom. And then the teen room with its beds there and exercise equipment and desk area. And yeah, up to the third floor where we have all of this science-y stuff and the master bedroom, which you're just peeking into right there. That's why they need curtains and their tiny, tiny little closet. And then onto the deck, which is really nice at nighttime. That bar looks great. I love how everything lights up and the little workstation. That's the deck at daytime. So that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Let me know what I should do for future episodes. And I'm really happy to be back building in The Sims. I hope you guys are glad to have me back. These are hopefully going to be a weekly series. So if you like what you see, please consider subscribing. I'm going to do these every week. And thank you guys again for watching, and I hope to see you guys really, really soon, and have an awesome day. Bye!